Hey, you! I need you to hit that subscribe button. Subscribe.
Y'all know y'all are Israelites?
Yeah, yep.
Okay, what tribe you from, bro? How you doing, sis? What's your name? Jessica. Okay, look at this sign right here. Let me know where your father's from. What would he be? Would he be a so-called African-American? Or be a Jamaican, a Haitian, Mexican, Puerto Rican? Puerto Rican? Okay, good. What about you?
My son is, you know, I put him over here to hear y'all talking. My son, you know, he more into this stuff, so.
Okay.
But he can't see, so he
that's cool, that's cool. So you're from you would be a so-called African-American, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So what I want to tell you is, according to the Bible, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the children of God. What that means is you're special people. That means every other nation is not a child of God. Y'all get that?
Okay.
Have you heard that before?
Yeah.
Y'all go to church?
I hear that, but yeah.
Okay, y'all go to church. So church teaches that God loves everybody, that we're all his children. He's going to come take us all back into heaven, right? That's what he said. That's what they say in church. That's what you're taught. Let's see what the Bible says. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Let's start with that. Because we're going to listen to what God says, supposed to what man says. All right? Man says celebrate birthday. God says don't celebrate your birthday. The lady says she's content with celebrating her birthday, so there's a judgment for that. Lord's will she repents, but there's a judgment coming for that.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
All right, so this is Deuteronomy. This is when Moses led the children of Israel out of Egypt. Y'all familiar with that story? Let my people go. Let's go.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
God said you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are a holy people. The word holy means to be separate, set apart, cleansed from everybody else. All right, keep going.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
He chose you, the nation of Israel,
to be a special people.
Like, you got a special outfit you like to wear, sis? You got a special, like, this is my favorite outfit right here. It's my banging thing right here. Or you got a favorite pair of shoes. And you said, oh, this is my go-to thing right here. God says he has a special people, same way. Keep going.
Unto himself, above.
Hold on. He says he has a special people above. Read it again.
Above.
Hold on. It didn't say equal to. You notice that? It didn't say equal to.
Yeah.
Keep going.
All people.
All nations. The 18 nations in the Bible that's recorded. We're set above every single one of them. Thus saith the Lord thy God. That's what he said. He set their presence for us to be above every nation. There is no equality, so when you hear someone talk about God loves everybody, challenge that. Read that part again.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
All right, give me Malachi 3 and 6, because a lot of people will say that we're lying, all right? A lot of people will say God changed that. We're going to show you something according to the Bible. It says, you go to church, right? Sometimes. But look, don't ever go back to church. You're not going to learn nothing there. They're not teaching you nothing but lies.
That's right.
All right? Let me ask you a question real quick. You celebrate the Passover?
No.
What about tabernacles?
No.
What about the new moon?
No.
Okay. You celebrate your birthday?
No.
Oh, good. That's good. What about Christmas?
Yeah.
All right, give me Christmas real quick. Give me Christmas. I'm going to show you something, sis, because God has it to where we celebrate Passover, New Moon, Pentecost. These are holidays set aside for our people only, all right? If you can't find it in this book, we're not supposed to celebrate it.
Right.
All right? We don't find birthdays in there, so we don't celebrate birthdays. We don't find Thanksgiving, which is the murder of your people. See, give me that sign right there. That sign.
No.
That one. There we go. Check this out, sis. Bring it over here. Check this out, sis. People like to celebrate Thanksgiving, right? Look what happened to your people. This is what happened to your people.
Taino
Indians were taken and held captive and killed and sent everywhere else except on their land. That's what happened to your people, sis. This is documented. Your oppressor did that to you. All right? This is in the Bible. All right? So why would we celebrate Thanksgiving if it's the slaughter and murder of our brothers and sisters, it doesn't make sense.
See,
thank you. So, get this real quick.
Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel.
It said, O house of what? Israel. There you go. So who's the Lord talking to? Talking to the same people that standing around you, all your brothers and sisters right here. So-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Read it from the top.
Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Verse 2. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen.
He says, learn not the way of the heathen. Same as envy not thou oppressor. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways. Anything that our oppressor does, we are not supposed to follow that. He celebrates Christmas. We're not going to celebrate Christmas, but we're going to prove it to you.
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Don't get into astrology. We don't do that. We don't get into all the Pisces and Leo, Lion, and all that stuff. We don't do that. God said not to do it, so we're not going to do it. Keep going.
For the heathen are dismayed at them. For the customs of the people are vain.
The customs of these other nations are vain. They have nothing to do with our people. Keep going.
For one cutteth a tree out of the forest.
Uh-oh. It says one cuts a tree out of the forest. Sound familiar? Keep going.
The work of the hands of the workman with the axe.
He cuts it with an axe. Keep going.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
They deck it with silver and gold. What does that sound like so far?
Christmas.
Sounds like Christmas. Let's see if it is. Excuse me.
They fasten it with nails and with hammers.
They got them nails at the bottom so it stands up straight. It says not to do that. God sets us apart from all the other nations because that's an old Babylonian custom.
Right.
All right. So let me ask you this, sis. You going to celebrate Christmas?
I don't even know.
You don't know? But sis, remember, this is your heritage. Your heritage is the Passover. Because remember, the Most High God sent Moses to lead us out of captivity from Egypt. All right. Now, if we do celebrate Christmas, what do you think we're going? What do you think we're doing? We're going back into Egypt. We don't want to go back because there's a punishment when we go back. You want to be free from that. You want to be on top of everybody. Remember that. As long as you're thinking like them, you're not on top. You're at the bottom. You're just right. Like everybody else. Okay. So we need to be above everybody and celebrate the Passover, tabernacles, new moons. These are things you can look up when you get home. The Sabbath. Like today is the Sabbath. Today's the Sabbath. Like today is a day of rest for us. Okay? You ever heard about the Sabbath?
Yeah.
What day is the Sabbath on?
Saturday.
There you go. You're smart with that. I like that. But what does Christianity tell you that the Sabbath day is?
Sunday.
Why would they lie to you, sis? They don't care about you. Right? All right, give me what you got?
Exodus.
Get that real quick.
Exodus chapter 20 verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Now remember, this is in Exodus years ago. He's telling them to remember the Sabbath. Why is he telling them to remember it? Because he knows one day we're going to forget it and to bring it back to our memories. Okay? Read that part again.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
And remember what I said. Holy means to separate it. So this day is going to be separate from the other 6 days. Keep going.
Verse 9. 6 days shalt thou labor.
6 days shall you labor. Keep going.
And do all thy work.
Now what that means is your work as far as your job, you know, the chores around your house, things of that nature. Like I got to make sure my grass is cut. My wife makes sure the clothes is folded and everything cleaned up. Make sure all that's done within those 6 days. That's what it's talking about. Keep going.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
All right. The Sabbath day is a day of rest. We are not supposed to do none of that, okay? Because God gives you a certain day to set apart so you can rest your body from all the work you did. Because remember, the Lord made the world in how many days?
Seven.
He made
well,
it what?
Six.
There you go. What are you doing that seventh day?
He rested.
So he wants us to have that same rest, all right? So if we don't rest, what are we doing? We think we're better than God. We think we're smarter than God. I can work 7 days. I can do this. Are we better than God? Can't be. All right, keep going.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou nor thy son nor thy daughter.
So your sons, your daughters shouldn't be doing it. Everybody in your household should be resting on this day. This is the day that we commemorate and we rest and we focus on the Lord. Do what he does. We go over scriptures with the brothers. We gather. We do things of that nature. All right. So that's one thing you need to start doing. So just come together with your brothers, the people that's going to teach you the laws of this Bible.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.